receiver, we all know this has been an issue since the offseason began. We knew it was going to be a mess in terms of the depth chart. It got much worse when Anquan Boldin suddenly retired and they traded Sammy Watkins. And Jordan Matthews comes over in a trade and gets hurt his first day of practice. Right now, it is a complete up-in-the-air situation. We think that Jordan Matthews will be back for the opener, so you got to figure he'll start next to Zay Jones, the rookie. After that, I've got four guys in here who I've picked who I think will make the team. Quite honestly, none of these guys might make the team, and they might go with four others. That's how jumbled a mess it really is. The guys I have making it are Brandon Tate because of his return ability. I think Rod Streeter, I think they'll save a place on the roster. He's got that toe injury. We really haven't been updated as to how serious that is, but I think he had a pretty good training camp in preseason before he got hurt. So I think they're going to keep him. He'll be inactive, obviously, on game days if he can't play. But I like him. I think he should be on the team. The other two guys I have are Andre Holmes and DeKyle Schwartz. Now, DeKyle Schwartz, I'm kind of rolling the dice. They could easily go to Brandon Riley, Dez Lewis, Philly Brown. I think they're going to cut Philly Brown, despite him being a veteran. He could make the team, though, just because of that. So the DeKyle Schwartz pick that I have here, very tenuous, but I roll the dice. We'll see what happens. The Andre Holmes thing is interesting because he's got the NFL experience. He's actually been playing. He's actually gotten some starts in the preseason out of necessity. But, you know, there's been some talk. You've seen some articles written about this compensatory pick that the Bills could attain next year, a third-round pick in 2018, if they cut a certain number of free agents that they signed. Andre Holmes is one of the guys who figures into that metric. So I could see the Bills. Vlad Dukas, an offensive lineman, is another guy. Kicker Steven Hauschka, who I don't think they're going to cut, falls into that. Defensive end Ryan Davis. If they cut a certain number of these guys, they could be eligible to pick up that third-round pick. And we all know that this administration values picks.